presentation, it was kind of a little difficult to come up with a presentation for, you know, there's so many needs, and people who have come from Zangtab and Meda Clan know what those needs are, and it's really hard for me in such a short period of time to describe the things that I saw, the feelings that I got, the stories that I have, because I could go on and on and on. So I'm going to try to do this in the easiest way possible. What I'm going to do is I'm going to split this presentation up into two different things. The first, I'll just do a quick slide. It's going to be a quick slideshow and a song. It's going to be the pictures that I took during the first 3 months that I was there. During that first 3 month portion, you know what? Let me backtrack a little bit. Hi, I'm Steve Barr. I'm an environmental engineer. I was invited to go to Cameroon by getting in this family and also by the clan head. I've been working with groups like Engineers Without Borders and Safe Water International and other NGOs in water-related fields. And I was kind of called to do this by Gideon and his family and the clan head to come to the village and assess what the problems are, to look at, you know, some potential solutions. So I stayed there from the months of February until September of this last year. So I guess I just got back, but you know, it's close enough. Yeah, it's still within this year. It's still in that photo album of this year. So yeah, that's pretty much who I am. Like I said, I'm an environmental engineer undergraduate. I'm working at an environmental consulting firm right now, and hopefully going to be going on to do my master's degree here in August in international development. So this is kind of thank you. So this is kind of what. So this is you know, my passion. Like it, you know, it was partially my training, but mostly my passion. And so I went and lived in the village for about 7 months, trying to understand the way people live, what the problems are. And as an engineer, I've always been told, you know, one to solve a problem or something like that, to solve a problem, one must first define one's scope. You know, to what extent is the problem? Like, what is the problem? What are we looking at? So the first slideshow I made up there, it's just called Walking and Talking. So that's pretty much what I did for 3 months. Just walked and talked to everyone. You know, walked around to all the places, saw everything, and just talked with a bunch of people. There wasn't a period of time where I was teaching or anything like that for the first 3 months. It was all surveying, asking questions, getting answers, asking the same question, getting different answers, So that was pretty much the first 3 months. And the second 3 months is when we actually started from taking the information that we got during those first 3 months and then coming together and saying, okay, well, this is what you guys told me. Now how do we go about, you know, working together to solve these problems just within the community? And so, to have a change of pace in music, here's a slideshow so I have to talk less. And, go ahead. Okay, I don't have to talk anymore. And I know it's supposed to be saying Tabby and I.
It's
okay. Proper grammar.
Just leave.